Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr. Marston.
John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
I was trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. See my hat?
I have. And what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later? Help me patrol the perimeter. You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind. Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
Well, no time to waste. The horses are saddled up over here. There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
Okay, let's see if you can still ride a horse. Come on, time for you to see what a real ranch looks like. Is the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
Well, hello there.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better.
Whoa.
Come on, boy. And here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarland.
Well, are we going inside? How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarland.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. Come on, then. Let's mount up and take a look around. Let's go. Keep your eyes open and try not to get yourself shot again. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. I don't believe it. Those damn rabbits are back. Give me a hand with them, will you? Let's see that rifle. I want a couple of these for the pot. Good shot! That's it! Kill those little varmints! Bet you thought I couldn't use this, didn't you? Thank you, Mr. Marston. Looks like we'll be having rabbit stew tomorrow. Let's mount up and patrol the rest of the property. Let's get going. We've still got plenty of ground to cover. If it's not the rustlers stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure.
Damn coyotes are back! We can't afford to lose any more livestock. Kill them, Mr. Marston! You know, you can actually handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
This is you, Mr. Marston. Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep, and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarlane.
Please be aware of the social disease carried by a certain young lady.
That Bonnie is a ripe girl.
There's a change of season in the air.
She wouldn't look at me, though.
My patient's bone.
I got work to do.
Those folks in Thieves Landing have been sniffing around here again.